What's good, fellas? What's good?
Damn, Carlos, you wear hats indoors too? That's crazy.
I know, that's what I was thinking.
Yeah.
Sometimes.
Yeah, it's funny.
Looking, I love that. That's a dope ass towel, man.
You're gonna not believe this, but I miss you guys.
Miss you too, man.
Damn. We haven't played like in how many months now?
Since that backyard party.
New Year's.
What backyard? Oh yeah, we did that little sink thing.
Little sink vibe.
Little sink vibes. Blunts everywhere. Hollywood types.
Yup. We killed it though. We were ready to go. We were ready for Coachella. Super ready for Coachella. But you know, We're gonna be ready when we hit the stage again. We're gonna give everybody some time to listen to this record at least, you know?
That's it.
I was wearing the hat because I went to run errands and then I forgot it was on. But I'm going to keep it on now. True. So thanks for asking, Eduardo.
Take the head from the corona.
From the sun.
Oh, the sun. That's the first
part. I have to go buy produce today in Echo Park. There's like this place that you like order it straight from the farm. It's supposed to be pretty legit. So
what you get?
We got Swiss chard, I see. And some scallions, it looks like. Lettuce. A bunch of green stuff. Veggies. No fruit.
Cool.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right, here we go. Color My Life.
All right, let's play this, man.
You have to.
Hell yeah. That's the next level, man. That's the next sound. Like, we're reaching these places. We are just flying with this new music. So I was just so excited to. I was just like, I wanted already to come out so people can enjoy this music. So when actually that was the first song that he came out, I was just so positive, so excited about it.
Yeah, that shit made me tear for sure. I was like in my studio out in my little apartment out in Chinatown, listening to the headphones, and I smoked the bowl. I made some time, you know what I'm saying? I was just like, all right, I'm going to listen to this. And I listened to it, and I was like, oh, my God. I started crying, you know? That's like the first time I've ever experienced that on any kind of recording. And I was just like, okay, this is now the new foundation. And from here, we're just going to go up and up and up. And, you know.
Because, you know, it was blood, sweat, and tears in the making.
Tears, that shit was blood, sweat, tears, fucking shit.
I remember I was in the jewelry district in downtown with the homie Brandon from Han Solo. He's helping me find an engagement ring. And I remember I was so busy and stressed out that day. You know, it's a big deal trying to find the right ring. And I remember I get like the email from Sean, and it was like, here's the first round of mixes. And then, of course, I sent them to all of you guys immediately, and I couldn't hear it, like, because I was, like, running around doing errands, and normally I'd, run to my studio or my car and play it loud, but I had to wait, 2 hours, and it was killing me. And I remember Leon texted me, and he was like, yo, he freaked the record. It sounds incredible. He was like, I cannot believe this. And it was just, like, the anticipation. When I finally got in the car and heard it, same thing Gabriel felt. I was just like floored.
Well, let's play Black Slate.
Oh, yeah. Let's do it. Hello, I just want you in my life. And now I'm so excited to feel everything you got inside of your soul now. Everything you got inside of your soul now. I just want to feel
thank you.
also funny about this song is, you know, there's people that are longing for the old sound, you know, the old keyboard on, you know, this record a little bit. We're not saying it's not there, but it is there on this song. We use Bardo's old school keyboard for the drum machine beat that's on this record, on this song.
That's right.
Right, right, Bardo?
Keys too. We use also, yeah. I have it right here actually. We use it for certain pads on this song. It's in there.
It's in there.
It's funny. It's like the first keyboard, like the one that we used for like Itotiani and like the first demo. Like we use it. We actually use the drum machine that's on there too. Like I'm very proud of that.
That's awesome.
Also, Blank Slate is our first track. It's the first track that we put together. Like literally, it's pretty amazing. I guess I want to reiterate some of the things that I've been talking about or like in interviews and whatnot. For me, like this song was just kind of like, yo, let me put together some vibes that Miguel would sing to, you know, like it was around the time that we rocked that Me Too session with him. And I was super inspired to do something that's super fresh and super modern, just to give some context and like the inspiration or some inspiration behind it, you know? And it went through, this track must have gone to how many versions? Like 3 or 4 versions before this finished product that we just heard right now. So
I remember we left Sean Everett's when we gave him like all the math, the stems, and he said, is there anything you don't want me to, And we're like, just do your thing. And I remember telling him, hey, Sean, let's get some explosions, bro. Like explosions everywhere. And on this one, man, I just want to boom,
boom,
like fucking rodeo, like just like sends it off into like explosion every time.
I love that little dub vibe at the end, you know. You know,
yeah, that's dope too.
And that Blade Runner, that Blade Runner synth that Leon added into it. That Leon. Anyways, yeah, so much.
I like the Atomic Dog backward snare drop on the second chorus, the double chorus at the end. Oh yeah. That's my favorite part.
All right, let's put on the next one.
I don't.
that's a fun one.
MVP, Bardo Martinez on that solo.
Thank you, brother.
Yourself, bro.
Appreciate that. Thank you.
That's fucking dope. That's just like one of those memorable Guitar World, you know, page 35, you know, a little section in the back, how to play the guitar solo.
Thank you, man. So much. Yo, I will say, had to get one in, man. Carlos got so many, you know what I'm saying?
You know, everyone's got to fight for the right party, bro.
Carlos killed it on the record, man. He has so many dope solos. It's nuts. From Color My Life to, like, Polymetronomic Harmony, which y'all going to hear. And anyways, man.
My favorite part of this song was when we recorded. I wanted to try this thing. I recorded my bass through a tiny, tiny little PV amp what's that band that does what's that band's name?
Kings of the Stone Age.
Kings of the Stone Age recorded their album through, and I put a wah-wah through there, like a Morley wah, and then Bardo hated that shit.
I fucking hated it.
Yeah, turn it off, like, and then telling like a control room, Leon, hey, can you like mute that? And I was just like, it was like fire just coming through me. I was just like, just ignore him. I was like, that's my vibe, bro. Ignore him.
I'm glad you did.
When we went to the control room, like, you understood what my intention.
Oh, it really opened my mind.
That's all you heard when we were playing, like this wah bass on this little tiny, like, 8-inch speaker.
It sounded like shit. We were playing it. It sounded like shit. Yo, let me tell you though. Like, it was one of those things where it's one of those moments where you're like, yo, I didn't get it at all. But then as soon as I heard it back in the control room, it was just like, fuck, Eduardo's right. Like, it's just like, it was brilliant. And it's something that I didn't get. But it's those moments that really like open you up. And just wow. And it's just like, dang, it just flips you in the best way though. Cause you fucking, I love that bass sound now. It's just so grainy and gritty and raw. And it's like, I don't know. It reminds me of like, honestly, this song, you know, it reminds me of like, have you guys heard that song by Childish Gambino? California. You guys heard that song?
Yeah. I've heard that one.
Like
yeah.
The rhythm kind of reminds me of that. But anyways, yeah.
Gabriel. The syndrome. Thank you for bringing that out. Yeah, the syndrome. It sounds like a clave. It's actually that electronic drum set from the, that's like from the 70s or 80s, right?
Yeah. Analog syndrome.
That's what you used on this one? I was wondering what's going on the drum.
That's what it's going on there. Like, man, it was so fun.
You triggered it while you were playing
live. I'm playing it live, just one patch of the syndrome, and it's changing pitch, so it sounds like a clave. Toque, coque, 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 coque. I'm just doing a very simple, like, and I was just like, hey, I don't have to do much, you know? Like, the less I play, the more it sounds good.
The demo sessions in my studio, Gabo and I would just fuck around with that shit, like, for hours, you know? And just tweak things. And then, when we went to the session, Gabo was like, trae el syndrome. And I was like, all right. It's the same, like, it's not certified until you put some syndrome on it. And I think the song just fucking got certified with that on there.
Go
ahead, Carlos, sorry.
Okay. I remember we were tracking it because it went from that, like, other, like, 16th note hi-hat vibe that we had on the demo. And then when Leon was leading it towards this, I was like, damn, it sounds like some 80s, like, African. Like, cool.
Yeah.
Totally.
What are you saying, Bardo?
He's playing the clave.
Let's say that. Yeah. Everybody was just playing rhythm. It was just like Leon got on that little guitar and
Oh, that's right.
And everybody would just lock into that pocket. And I was just playing like this funky 70s keyboard, like Italian synth thing.
Well, that's you.
Yeah.
Oh shit!
I remember I was in the ISO booth, like on the other side of the control room or whatever. And I remember I was like happy that I wasn't next to you guys during this song because I remember you guys were arguing about the bass.
I put my head down.
I don't know what's going on over there, but I'm having fun right now.
I put my head down.
Yeah, he doubled down on that shit. That was great.
I didn't back off on that shit.
There's nothing to talk about. There's nothing to talk about.
Yeah. Came on great.
Hell yeah.
Next track. Guys, give me a minute. I'm gonna go get some food for my baby.
All right, for sure.
All right. Face on.
All right, here we go. Invisible People. Those beats are so heavy. So heavy. Yeah. Yeah.
I love the space, man.
Down. We slowed that, you know, Leon slowed that one down for sure.
Hell yeah.
It was one of it was an old school demo. Old school demo for like the Johnny Walker joints, right? And we slowed that shit down.
We used that machine, the Maestro, right?
Oh yeah,
we were playing it into that yeah. So we slow it down, and then we were playing to that rhythm, and you just hear it when it comes, the chorus comes. You hear the machine on the back, like it's playing like a little clave and a little thing going on. but we were playing it to that rhythm. So it was just like in the space, you know, all the, it elevates and then like drops, well, boom. And you know, like it comes all strong. Like it's great. Oh, it's just like so much space.
I can't wait to play this song live. It's such a, I feel like it's such a song. It's such a festival song, you know, it's so big and the chorus is so big or whatever. It's just like, I don't know, man. I could just imagine like a, just summertime, just like the multitude, just like, just getting down on it, you know?
We wrote this song like what, like in 2 hours or something before we, well, we guys, we had to rearrange it.
What do you mean?
Didn't we like, because Leon wasn't feeling the demo, so then we rewrote it on the spot, remember, before we tracked?
Oh, yeah. We did it, like, in 2 hours. Like
2 hours, well, right?
Hour and a half? Amount of time, and we spent a lot of time on this song.
Felt like 2 hours. It just felt like it went by pretty quick. The parts came together.
We chopped it up. We really chopped it up.
All about changing those gears. Like, we were giving it a lot of space. It was, the demo was, the brrr, you know, and we started playing, like, boom, pa, boom. No more like hi-hats, no more anything, just like all those like keys. That's the space right there, then the vibe, you know, like it was just like get ready because we're here on the studio, we're changing, just flipping out the whole thing, the demos upside down. So okay, but it's a great suggestion by Michaels, man.
Yeah, totally. It was because the song was had a lot of changes and it was fast, so it was relatively short. But then as soon as we slowed it down with all those parts included, it just dragged on to like 5 minutes. So yeah, a lot of the stuff, feeding his kid, doing his duties, invisible people. We're vibing on invisible people right now, just talking about how, you know, we chopped it up and slowed it down and just how like such a, you know, how it's like such a headbanger, you know, such a like strong, powerful track. Can't wait to play it, you know? Yeah.
Yeah. I just had a baby. So shit, this is crazy, man. It's like life don't stop. You know, it's my first time being a dad. So I know, Bartolo, you got two babies. You got one, but it's like, it's a 24/7 experience, and it's a blessing to be in quarantine with the baby. But it's time to look out for my wife, look out for the baby. Baby's crying, I put him to sleep. There's so many variables, and much love to all the parents out there that stick around and really do their job, man, because it's tough, but it's so rewarding, man. I'm in love with my wife. I'm in love with my baby. I'm in love with my life, and I just would love a little bit more sleep. A little bit more sleep. So here we are. We're doing it, baby. Invisible people. That's I remember when Leon said, let's slow this down. Everybody was like, okay. You know, okay. And we went
so
with it.
I was
and
so in it.
Fuck. It just turned out legendary. Your vocals, Bardo, they really resonated. It became like more anthem-y, you know, than this like this jam we had going on in the beginning.
Right.
Everything sunk in once we slowed it down by like fucking less than half beat.
Bro, my vocals switched like all the way up to like recording them in the studio. Like, you know, after we had tracked it, you know, after going to New York and recording it, it was just nonstop pen and paper, just like scratching out vocals, scratching out lines, just simplifying it to just get to the point, you know, because it was really about, like you said, just really making an anthem, you know.
Yeah.
And hopefully everybody feels it that way, you know? So let's move on to the next joint.
The other day my uncle told me a story. He said, son, he gets up with glory. Some heavy contraband. The gift for him he wasn't there, they came for me. The drug cartel made me a refugee. Two motorcyclists came.
wow, dude. Like, that's a fucking song, dude. I remember I was impressed as fuck. You floored me. I was just like, wow, that's okay. We have another song.
It was just like, easy, man.
This no record. One does shit, like, in terms of changes. You nailed that shit.
Thanks, man. No, it was easy. You know, we have a few tracks like that on the album where, you know, and I'm talking about, like, in demo stages, right? Where, like, you guys would come up with the, you know, with the track, you know? Pink Elephant, Manuel Story, I Know It, Wounds. Like, you know, you guys pretty much tracked the stuff when I wasn't there for the, like, any instrumentation. And it was just like, wow, this is dope. I'm ready to just rock with it and have fun writing the song, writing the lyrics. So yeah, Manuel Story came out dope as fuck. Should I play the joint? All right, here we go.
Shifting everywhere, above the ground, I'm flying through the air, right past the crowd, my heart is screaming loud. This moment of joy is thrilling me, this moment of joy is keeping me. This moment of joy is a light that shines every day. Me and you, here to catch a view. My sails, like an eagle moving in a flash, a light that shines is infinitely precious. This moment of joy is thrilling me. This moment of joy is keeping me high. This moment of joy is a light that shines every day.
Moment of joy towards the end, what we just heard, there's like a little tape delay echo. Have you guys heard that? It sounds like it's like a or something, but it's super like in the mix. But I think that was like after my take, I had like screamed or something. I was like, yeah, or something like in the studio. And I think he kept it in there, put it in the mix, and just put a delay on it. It's super. It's like hard to like hear it, but I'm super psyched that it's in there.
That's my favorite song for the album for sure, man. Sleeper hit. I remember this is the only song we had to track twice. We tracked it right. Once, and then Leon came back. And we had to track it again, and we tracked it so fucking low. I remember seeing Gobble was like this. Gonna give him a chopstick. Play that shit. He was playing so low, and I had to play like so light, and I was just like, I'm fucking dying, dude. So much tension, man. You have to be the shock absorber to get that shit fat as fuck. But you know, it was like one of the most intense songs I've ever had to record.
For the bridge part, I remember when I was just like writing it, I was kind of like, I was thinking of like Tim Maia. Like there's this one Tim Maia song that I was kind of vibing on, and I kind of threw that in there. Anyways, just remember.
Yeah, Tim Maia has that whole like, hey, like he just goes on, and then you know the guitar's in the back, and I love it, man. You did great on this. You fucking came through hard on those synths too. You came through hard on that shit. That's just our West Coast rep. Representation.
Everybody killed that shit. Carlos with the rhythm guitar. That song is, like you said, like it's on some G-funk shit.
That one was easy. That one was easy. Yeah. We all just fucking came together in that.
Moment of joy. All right.
That's side A already. That's like.
That's the end of side A, everybody.
Yeah.
Side B, here we go.
Elephant in the room. She's a mercenary with perfume. Just like in the movies, she kills for fun. Decapitating heads like the Shogun. Elephant in the room.
Wow. My God.
Wow. 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 Are we a hip hop band now?
Oh, yeah, wow. That
shit. Big! What is this fucking trash?
I hate this shit. What is this? I wish these guys would just go back to being how they were 10 years ago.
Get their fucking sellouts.
You guys suck.
Where's that chill, Chicano Batman?
I wish they would bring back the organs. I'm not feeling this. Be yourselves.
Those are Russell tuxedos.
That's like saying, when people say that, that's like, are you still wearing the same chones you wore 10 years ago? No, you changed. You got to change.
You got to get some new ones.
You got to get some new ones.
Hey, yo, get your new chonies, yo.
Get your new chonies, dude. Kirkland. You know what I'm saying? St. Cotton.
In order to be that pink elephant, you gotta play that King Kong vibe, you know? Bitch.
For all yous out there that are complacent on some shit, try something new. You might actually like it. You know what I'm saying? That to us is fucking around, having fun, man.
Just having fun, y'all. We're just having a good ass time. We're just like, you know, trying to lean into that shit. Like, you know?
It's a good song. Yeah. It's all there. It's all in the music.
Car wash.
You guys are fucking sellouts, dude. I just want to say that.
Pay me! Show me the money.
And for all you fools out there that gave us a lot of love on this shit, respect. You guys are with it. You guys have been with us. We're 11 years going strong now. And much love and appreciation to you and for your open minds, yo.
That's next fun. Truck.
Next truck.
Let's go.
Thank you. it's too polyrhythmic for me. The polyrhythmic, centronomic harmony.
I did an interview with some guy, and this guy in the Netherlands, and he was asking me about that song. He's like, I looked up Google, and there's actually not a polymetronomic harmony. What is that song about? And I was like, I don't know. And I was like, sounds cool. You like it, right? He's like, yeah. I was like, I don't know. That's all you need to know.
Now to look at the Urban Dictionary. Act.
Just fucking move. Just move.
All right, listen to the next one. What we got?
I can't stop reflecting upon the reflection of my own reflection. It's like a mind game that I can't tame. Like an empty shell that feels no pain. Just like the body is twitching, convulsing in every direction. We are a fragmented shard of glass, with minds fixated on the past.
Standing ovation.
Maybe this clap, like the highbrow clap, though.
Like, we all know Gabo has crazy motherfucking ideas. You know what I'm saying? This one was definitely one of them.
It was like,
you know what we need at the end? We need like a symphony, like an orchestra, you know? And I was just like, wow. So then they set that shit up. In one morning before we all came in, and then And then he did it. That shit goes on for so many times. It's so dramatic. This does in the Duda golf. ¿Cómo se hace, güey? En Venezuela.
El Duda, güey. El Duda, sí. El Duda,
man. Oh, that shit is dope, man. That shit is
That's definitely the song I hit the harder on the toms, and we were on the big room, and that was like using those like acoustics and just like going, whoa, the hell, you can feel that. So
yeah, that's, this track is so fire. Like, it's just so good. It was one of my least favorites at the beginning, but like the more I listen to it, the more it grows on me. Just because I was just, you know, I've been leaning on like all the straightforward kind of like pop vibes on this record. But this song is so Chicano Batman with it, you know, with all the time, all the changes and all that stuff, you know.
Leon was pushing for this one.
All school heads out there, you know.
This was Leon's like favorite track, I feel like. It felt like that way. He was like, wanted it.
Oh yeah.
He wanted it bad.
He got it on the album.
And he gets on it too. He gets on that Moog and the breakdown. So good. Big up to Money Mark. Money Mark from the Beastie Boys. He let us borrow his OG, his Moog mini, what is it? The so many Moogs.
Money Mark.
Moog. Bringing the Moog for us to get down.
Money Moog.
Money Mark with the mini Moog.
All righty then. All right, next song.
Next song.
Now do you need a glass? It all seems like a fable, yeah. Whatever you feel, I feel just the same. How about we just stop playing this game? Oh Lord, I'm surrounded by hustlers.
Took me a long time to like it. Long time. I just couldn't find myself in it. You know, it was like Like, I tried, like, so many different bass lines, and I was like, I don't know who I am anymore. And that one pushed me to find a new identity as a bass player and to like, serve the purpose of the song even further, like, further. Just how, like, at one point, I had a tune out to be like, I don't know what I'm doing, as, and just be like, how can you make the song better, you know? And that's just, you have to surrender to making the songs better, you know, and not about your playing.
You really played that like a bassist from the 80s, man, like a funk bassist. It was crazy. So I guess, like, it's so minimal, and it's so, but it's like not in the way at all. But at the same time, you are being busy. It's weird. It's just like boom, 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 boom. I love that shit.
Boom, boom. I hate Carlos forever for that intro line, because I just wanted to start on the one. One, two, three, four, boot. He was like, no, start. So I have to do that line, and it kills me. It's so hard, because it's like on the D string, you know, and then I have to hit the first fret, the F, and then it's not a guitar, you know what I'm saying? It's just like, and it's so, hate you, dude.
I love that entrance.
One time I took it off, Carter was like, no, you gotta bring that back, man. That's funky. I was like, oh, yo, here we go. I was like, yeah, I thought he forgot.
So, I remember.
Give it up to Carter.
Good. Good. I remember because I was looking at it on like the keyboard, and it's easy on keyboard, but I remember like trying to play it on guitar, and I was like, well, Eduardo has big ass hands, so you should be able to play it on the bass.
I still hate you. But yeah, but I remember this one was like super Michael Jackson-y. Like, that was like when we were in the demo mode, it was just like popping, 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 you know? And that was fun about this. Super popping, popping, you know? We had never really done that kind of thing before.
It was so much fun.
Like, you know, we just went full on.
Yeah.
It might have been like the intention, but it felt more like, came out to me like Talking Heads vibe. Sorry, were you going to say, Bartle?
No, I was just, yeah, I mean, I agree. It was just all 80s, like, vibes. No, I was just like, I had a different chorus, like, all the way up to, like, finished all my vocals. We're about to submit everything. We had like a week left. And so I just had to like, I wasn't feeling the chorus that we had. So I was just like, basically like fixing vocals at my house, you know, just like totally, it had to be poppy. It had to be poppy, you know? So I really went in with that intention on the chorus, and like, I'm super proud of it.
I remember the uncertainty of that, of your vocals, was driving Carlos insane.
I had to leave.
What's happening? It's different today. And then you come back, Barlow, with another fly aside. Barlow's like, Carl's like, I forget it. I don't even care anymore.
Just I like, remember, I left. I was just like, all right, I trust you guys. Like, I'll hear it on the record. That was when I heard it. It was on the record.
You said that. I trust you guys. I'm just gonna tap out now. I can't take this anymore. And then I remember, Barlow, you were like, I remember you showing me. I don't know how we did. You come into the studio. Did you play it? I don't know what we did, but bounce.
I had it kind of like I was just working on it. I don't know if it was just like the final stuff, or if it was like I was just working. I think I still kept on working on it after I showed you, but I was near finishing it, and so I think it was just like a mixed down MP3 of it, and then I just played it at your studio. Yeah.
Cool.
But yeah, that's how it went down.
I remember Gabo has some interesting transitions on that one, because, you know, you're doing like da da da, you know, and then it goes tuk. It's like, I remember seeing Gabo in the studio and he'd be like, fuck, fuck. Yeah. It's like the switch is so like instant. You're like in the mountains, and now you're in the sea. It's so instant, and like, it was just crazy.
Yeah, that syncopation was crazy going into that like 80s, like syncop, whoop, 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 you know, like to make that sound like steady and dancing, you know, dancing vibe. That's what you want. So, but I fucked up so many times.
I remember. Rey de la salsa, Gabriel, no joda. Wow. Solo rey de la salsa. All right, so I'm going to play the next one.
We'll be right back.
dancing in the morning. I feel much better now that you are here. You are the wind that moves the ocean. The sand beneath my feet that keeps you near.
Your melody, Gabo. You remember that?
Wait, the melody.
That was
super fun to make. Like the way we went into the creation of the song, everyone like doing like super ideas here, there. Bardo coming with the on the flow. You know, like we were on the studio, just like, hey, this is fun, man.
Last minute. Last minute is like the night before the midterms due. You know.
We're finishing the term paper. We didn't have like, there was no lyrics. That shit was tracked. Everything was done, but there was no like song yet because there was no like vocals on it. We weren't going to leave it as an instrumental. So yeah. So we were just, it was such a fun brainstorming session for sure. And yes, Gabo did come up with that melody. He definitely, I heard him like, we were just sitting there, just got everybody coming up with ideas, just kind of like, twiddling our thumbs, you know, like, and then I hear a gobble. I was like, what the fuck? I was like, yes, that's a dope melody. I remember feeling like, da-da, da-da. I was just bobbing my head to the rhythm, da-da, da-da. And then Eduardo joins me, he goes, da-da. I think I started saying Bella. It just happened like that.
True. That's so fun, so fun.
We got one more joint, y'all.
Thank you. all permanence. You make me shake in my sleep. I wish I could always keep you, so I would never feel.
Crazy how, like, yeah, in the process of making this record, like, we grew so much, you know, we just grew so much because we spent so much time, you know, just focused on it. Yeah, this song was the same, like, with a lot of other tracks, just like already sounding dope from the get, and it was just kind of easy to put together. Yeah, same here, you know. I was thinking about my uncle who passed away some years back. And, you know, I had a good, you know, it's just crazy. Life and death is just part of life, you know, and really, I feel like this is a song for everybody out there. It's something that we all have to deal with at some point or another. I think is a perfect closure to the record.
Also, it's special because of Stevie Wonder's pianos on it.
Oh, yeah.
Right.
Totally.
The studio had Stevie Wonder's piano from Talking Book and all those early 70s records. They rebuilt the studio around his piano, his grand piano.
One moment I remember from this track that was dope. It was Rafa Cardenas. He was there. He was a photographer for the session. And then he was listening to the track and he's like, I like it, man. It has that like El Michael's Affair vibe, you know? And then we're like, he's right here. He's like, what? Like, oh shit, that was surreal, dude. I was laughing so hard, man.
You know what, now that you say that, I wonder how many people
for the scenes
are fans of ours and fans of L. Michael's Affair probably do not know that Leon Michaels is L. Michael's Affair and that we've been working together the last 2 albums. That's
true. It's
probably true.
Leon Michaels, L. Michael,
L. Michael.
L.
All right.
All right. It's been fun.
Fun.
Congratulations. You guys killed it.
Good job, Bardo. Good job, Gabriel. Good job, Eduardo. Good job, Leon. Good job, Sean. Good job, Jens. Good job, Barefoot.
Good job, Jason. Good job, Brad. I'm saying good job, Amy.
What's up, ATO?
Good job, John. Good job, Paul.
It's right here.
Yeah.
It's right here. Get it.
2 years in the making. 2 years. Woo! Crazy.
Rala Choi.
Good job, fans.
Rala Choi.
For the shows.
Choi, you know, for the artwork.
You know?
Yeah. Let's go. We can't wait to see you when we see you.
2023.